When you're shopping for knives, one of the things you might hear about is the knife's tang. That is, how is the blade attached to the handle? And there are lots of different ways to do it. This Morataka has a Japanese-style wa handle. And this handle has a little cavity carved out. And if we were to take this blade out of the handle, you would see that the tang of the knife looks something like this. It's another piece of metal, usually a different type of steel that's not as expensive as the steel being used for the blade itself, attached on that hooks in. And that's what gives you a connection between the blade and the handle for that. These style of knives are not meant to be meat cleavers. They can use just a small extension into the handle, and they've got plenty of strength for the tasks that they're built for. This Wusthof, on the other hand, uses a different style, known as full tang. So you can see, revealed by the handle, that the spine of the knife actually goes all the way through. And this is so that you are inspired with confidence when you're whacking through chicken bones or cutting really hard foods that apply a lot of torque against the handle of this knife. But how about an ultrasonic knife? Well, we don't have the luxury of full tang construction because our handle has to fit a bunch of working parts. But it's still really important that you can use this knife for all your tasks in the kitchen. And so we poured a ton of engineering in making sure that the connection between the handle and the knife was going to stand up to abuse. How tough is this connection? Let me show you. This is an earlier prototype with a different blade finish, but the same internal construction. And I grabbed this because I'm about to abuse it. This is a normal scale that just measures in pounds. Let's see how much force I can apply with my hand. That's one hand. And that's two with all of the force that I can summon. But you may have noticed I am not a gym rat. So let's see if we can find an arm with a little more force. I've attached the knife to my lab assistant, J-Robot Choppenheimer, who has significantly more arm strength than I do. Now let's lower the knife down onto the scale very slowly and see how much force we can get. Crossing 13 pounds. 28 pounds, that's about as much as I could apply with one hand. At 35 pounds, that's more than I could apply with both hands. All right, we're north of 50 pounds. That is more than I could possibly do with both arms if I were really trying. So let's see how the blade survived. There we go. Same as new. Not a crack, nothing. Perfect shape. There's no way around it. This is a larger size knife handle. And the reason is we had to fit the electronics from this and the working parts from this commercial ultrasonic food cutter into the handle of an ordinary kitchen knife. So let's see how this handle size compares to some other knives that you might find in your kitchen. This is a global. This is a smaller size knife handle, so it's great for people who have small hands or just prefer a smaller handle size. Next is a Morataka. This is a Japanese wa style handle, which is actually a little bit longer than the handle of the C200. Of course, it's narrower as well, but I want you to see here that the difference in size, even for a Japanese style knife, is maybe not as extreme as it looks when the knife is by itself. This is a Wusthof, so this is your classic traditional Western style knife handle. And you can see that it is less thick than the handle on the C200, but otherwise comparably sized. Next is the Victorinox. This is a very popular knife among home cooks. Here is the handle size comparison. And you can see that we're not totally out of the ballpark. Finally, the Kramer by Zwilling. Now, this knife has been a workhorse in my kitchen for years. I find its handle to be very comfortable, but it is, of course, on the larger side. Now, despite it being a little bit larger than even some of the knives I have here, the handle of the C200 is remarkably comfortable. We've rounded off every corner and edge that you'll come in contact with, including the part of the spine up here that allows you to hold the knife in a pinch grip without any sharp edges against your skin. And despite how it might look, the center of balance of this knife is about right here. So when I put it down on the cutting board and let it go, you'll see that it balances itself just forward of that bolster. And that makes it very, very comfortable for extended use in any grip style you prefer for whatever task you have at hand. How heavy is an ultrasonic chef's knife? Well, we have to fit a lot of components in this handle, including a lithium battery at the back. And so this knife packs a little bit of heft, but let's compare that to some other common chef's knives you might see in your kitchen. First, in the featherweight category, is the Victorinox Fibrox, weighing in at just 166 grams. It has a short tang and this lightweight plastic handle, which makes it really, really quite light. Next is a Morataka. It's a longer blade and a small Japanese wooden handle, weighing in at 176 grams. When we move into the European style or Western style of knives, things get a little bit heavier. This Wusthof Classic weighs in at 270 grams. And then one of my personal favorites at home, the Kramer by Zwilling, weighs in at about 290 grams. And now for the C200. Well, it's no surprise that an ultrasonic knife has to pack on a little bit of extra mass. This one weighs in at 328 grams, which is less than 15% more than the Zwilling knife, and still less than 3/4 of a pound. So is it heavy on the spectrum of kitchen knives? Yes. Is it way out of its weight class? Absolutely not.